As for the Honorable Judge Steeble. Come in.
All right, everyone, this is the state of Alabama versus Boo Arthur Radley and the murder of Bob Ewell. We'll start with prosecution and then defense. Please state your role, and then when you're done with your role, go ahead and have a seat. Starting with prosecution, please.
I am Justine, and I'm the closing state.
I'm Mary, and I'm the closing state.
I'm Caden, and I'm directly questioning Mayetta.
I am Brendan, and I am directing Ms. Rainweather.
I'm Sammy, and I'm direct examining Stephanie Crawford.
I'm Angeli, and I'm crossing Scout Finch.
I'm Alan, and I'm crossing Jeb Finch.
I'm Michaela, and I'm crossing Boo.
I'm Eva, and
I'm Ms. Meriwether,
and I'm
Alex. Thank you. A little louder,
Alex. Hi, my name is Mary Ellen, and I'm the opening statement attorney. I'm Ben Holland, and I'm the closing statement.
I'm Brittany, and I'm the closing statement. I'm Afrashid, and I'm the final remarks.
I'm Jewel Bain, and I'm the direct attorney. Questions go.
I'm Yona Roy, and I'm the direct examination for John Hinch.
I'm Julie Juzenko, and I'm the direct examiner for Arthur Radley.
I'm Maisha, and I'm cross-examining Stephanie Crawford.
I'm Ariana Bonds, and I'm cross-examining Mayetta.
I'm Edward, and I'm cross-examining Ms. Mayetta.
I'm Scout Finch, and I'm
Ms. I'm Jeremy Finch. I'm Joseph, and I'm Arthur Radley.
Thank you. And you're also closing.
Scout. Yes.
Okay, as I stated earlier, we're all here because the state of Alabama has found Boo Radley to be accused of the murder of Bob Ewell. Prosecution, would you like to make an opening statement?
Taken away from you. This is a description of the trial of the Ewell family. And their father is taken away from them in a quick second, taken by a thief, an isolated, obsessed thief who leaves gifts and perfectly molded sculptures made of soap. This is an obsessed thief. And this thief doesn't come to take material things like paper or items. This thief comes to take life. This thief goes by the name of Boo Radley. Today, from the prosecution side, you will hear from Mayetta Ewell, the daughter of Mr. Ewell, may he rest in peace, Stephanie Crawford, and Miss Mayetta, two noble, reliable sources from the native, two natives from Macomb County. And they will make it clear that this man has done something terribly wrong to the Ewell family. Thank you.
Thank you, prosecution. Defense, would you like to make an opening statement?
Yes.
Your Honor, my name is Mary Ioli, and I am here representing the people of the state of Alabama in this action to make sure Arthur Radley is acquitted of the accusation of the murder of Bobby Orr. People of the court of Macomb, let me set the stage for you. On October 31st, an innocent Halloween night, a school costume pageant, a little girl and her older brother strolling home, paces behind them, drunk and stalking carefully, is Bobby Orr. Children paused and listened, thinking it was their friend Cecil trying to scare them. Suddenly, with feet pounding with murderous intent, he chased the kids down with determination. Help, help, Scout screamed at her brother Jem for help. As Mr. Ewell stood above her, slashing and stabbing, aiming to take her life. Jem, like a valiant brother, fought to protect her younger sister from the danger. But his efforts were to no avail because Mr. Ewell grabbed Jim's left arm roughly and shattered the bone without remorse. Unexpectedly, an innocent willed Arthur Radley swooped in and saved Jem and Scout from further injuries and saved the children from Mr. Ewell's evil intent. Today you will be hearing from Scout and Jem Finch and Mr. Arthur Radley, whose recaps of these events will show you that Mr. Radley should not be found guilty of the murder of Bob. Thank you.
Thank you, counsel. Prosecution, at this time, would you like to call a witness to the stand?
I would like to call up Ms. Mayella to the stand. Mayella, can you tell us your full name?
My full name is Mayella Violet Eagle.
Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm 19 years old. I'm the oldest out of all my siblings with no brother. I also love growing Blue Radley.
You're not a piece.
How do you know about Blue Radley?
I personally don't know Blue Radley, but I heard a lot of rumors about him in Macomb.
Can you tell us about those rumors?
I heard he stabbed his father with a pair of scissors. And he also dines on small squirrels and only cats he can catch.
Are you saying he's crazy?
Obviously.
Is it possible, since you're saying he's crazy, that he stabbed your father?
Yeah.
And that's it.
Defense, would you like to cross-examine this witness?
So you've been on stand before, right?
Yeah.
You know, testing and witnessing in Paul Robinson's case, right?
Yes.
Do you mind reading to me on page 248, this line, all the way to right here, to right here, please? Out loud.
No, I don't recollect if you hit me. I mean, yes, I think you hit me. Was your last sentence your answer? Yes, you hit. I just don't remember. It all happened so quick.
That's you saying that, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay. That sounds a little, like, unsure, doesn't it?
Yes.
Sounds a little confusing.
Well, obviously, I was stuttering and I was nervous, so.
How do we know that you're not nervous right now? But, so, when you were saying you didn't want to speak again, you kept saying, what is this on page? Read that for me, please.
Who beat you, Tom Robinson or your father? Did you scream first at your father instead of Tom Robinson? What was that?
So then again, it sounds just a little unsure of you, right? Like you don't want to answer the question because maybe you sound confused, right?
Yeah.
So you So you do sound confused. So you're unsure, right? But you just said yes.
Objection.
Yes, counsel.
The question was asked.
Asked and answered?
It was asked and answered.
Okay. Sustained. Go ahead and ask your next question.
So not only do you sound unsure, right? Okay. But you just, when he was talking to you, you sounded that you've heard a lot of rumors about Boo Radley. But in your other case, you were making other rumors about Boo Radley, so you have something against him?
Well, obviously he's crazy.
Is that another rumor?
Yeah, he's crazy. No.
You sound a little confused.
Make it in the form of a question, yes.
Okay. No further questions.
Okay, thank you. Prosecution, would you like to redirect your witness?
No. I know that, and may Ella be excused?
She may. Thank you. Okay. Prosecution, you may call your next witness.
So let's call up Miss Mayweather.
Bad impact on us.
I didn't even know who Bradley.
Well, I don't really know him personally, but I know things that really turn me against him.
Can you explain the rumors that you heard about him?
Well, he, I would say, physically abused his dad by stabbing scissors into him.
Why do you think that Boo Radley didn't attend the Halloween pageant that night?
Well, I feel as if he's a very unsocial person, and he just, like, won't communicate with anyone in our community.
That would be all.
Thank you, counsel. Would you like to cross this witness?
Yes.
Good evening, ma'am. I would like you to state your full name, where you're from, and your relationship with Boo Radley.
My name is Ms. Grace Merriweather. I live in the city of Macon. And I personally don't know Boo Radley.
Is it true that you talked to Stephanie Crawford?
Yes.
Have you heard the rumors about Boo Radley?
Yes.
Do you believe the rumors about Boo Radley?
Yes.
Why?
Because they're obviously true. He's an outcast in our community, and he obviously doesn't want to take part of anything. Of course, anyone would think about him that way.
Do you think he killed Bob Ewald?
Yes.
Maybe it's because you think he's crazy.
He is crazy.
Well, if you're saying the reason he killed Bob Ewald is because he's crazy, he usually stays home because he doesn't like being around people. And you're telling me that he killed Bob Ewald even though he knows he'd go to jail, where he'd be around a lot of people.
Is there a question in there, counsel?
I'm asking her if he killed Bob Ewald even though he knew that he would go to jail and be around a lot of people. When they're saying that he doesn't like being around people, and he's not a social person.
I see what you're trying to get at, I do. But put it in a question format with like a at the end.
Are you saying that Bob Yule, are you saying that Boo Radley killed Bob Yule even though he knew he'd go to jail?
Yes.
Well, he knew that if he went to jail, he'd be around people, and he's non-social, you said. Then why would he do it?
I'm sure they have special cells for people in that condition.
Would you say he's a creep?
He is.
On page 16, it says that Miss Stephanie Crawford said she woke up in the middle of the night one time and she saw him looking straight through the window. Since we all know that she created that rumor, would you still say she is a reliable source of information?
Yes, I completely trust Miss Stephanie Crawford.
Is it true that you said we don't have the sin on our shoulders down here? People up there set them free, but we don't see them sitting at the table with them, at least that we don't have the deceit to say to them, yes, you're as good as we are, but stay away from us. Is it true that you said that?
Yes.
Isn't it true that while saying that about the North, aren't you being a hypocrite yourself? Do you think it's important that...
Objection, Your Honor.
Please cancel.
The last statement was irrelevant.
Relevancy. Go ahead and defend the relevancy of that statement, counsel. Thank you, Mrs. Stain.
You're welcome.
If she's being a hypocrite herself, then why should she be trusted at court?
Thank you.
That makes
sense.
Do you believe that it is significant that Boo Radley's father died while he was at home?
Do I find this significant?
Yeah, you think that's important?
Yes.
Why do you find that important?
Because I don't understand the question. I
rephrase the
word. Okay, do you think it's important that Boo Radley was home while his father died?
Yes.
Why did you say that's important?
Because he's always gone. So.
Would you say that it's possible that in some way he killed his father?
Yes, I think so.
But if he killed his father, then why did the doctor say that his father died of old age?
Well, objection. It's not a yes or no question.
It doesn't have to.
It's costly.
Ask the question one more time so you can hear it.
I said, if he killed his father, then why did the doctor say that he died of old age?
Oh, I see what you're saying. Sustained. Ask the question again, but in a yes or no format.
I don't know how to do that. If you believe that he's crazy, why did the doctor claim that he died of old age? Doesn't that make you unreliable? Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you, Ms. Merriweather. That will be all. Thank you, Ron.
Thank you. Would you like to redirect your witness? Don't you necessarily
Yes.
You would like to? Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. Miss Meriwether sent the defense staff a question about Riley and his jail cell. What do you think?
Wait.
Riley wants to be around people, don't you say?
Objection?
No, no, yeah.
Objection?
Well,
wait, what is the objection, Campbell?
Relevance.
Sustain, get there.
Okay.
Get to wherever you're going.
So since he wants to make friends with Scout and Jem, don't you say?
Yes.
By drawing blankets to help Scout?
Maybe, yes.
So he wants to be around people.
Yes.
That would be all.
Thank you, Campbell.
Can Miss Naomi Weather be excused?
Yes, she can. Okay. Thank you. Prosecution, you can call your next witness.
Should I call Miss Stephanie Crawford?
Yes.
Why would you say he's a danger to the community?
Because he's isolated, and I have seen him do things to his father.
So what have you seen him do to his father?
When he came back from the camp that he was at, I saw him cutting stuff out for his scrapbook. And after, he took the scissors that he was cutting the stuff with, and he was stabbing it in his father's head.
And did you notice anything wrong about Riley that day?
Yeah.
So how would you have described him as a child?
As a child, he was really nice. He was a gentleman. But then he just stopped me.
And do you think that staying inside all that time affected him in any way?
Yeah.
How did it affect him?
Because he lost his social skills and he just, people thought him. I thought he was a danger to him. He wouldn't come out and
so, has he ever interacted with you?
Yeah. One night I woke up in the middle of the night and he was staring at me while I was sleeping.
And what did you expect of him to do next?
I don't know. I thought he was crazy.
So you thought he was crazy. And so you're saying he fits the description of an insane person?
Miss Stephanie Crawford, is it true that most people came to you for information in your neighborhood? Around 15 years ago, you were the one that claimed that Arthur Radley allegedly stabbed his own father. Is this true? And is it true that you received most of the information from your observations or from the other neighborhood ladies? And the information you received, is it reliable? Are you sure it's reliable? Yes, but isn't it true that on page 291 that you are neighborhood scold?
So, if you are known for stating information without any concrete evidence, then wouldn't those be considered baseless rumors?
Yes and no, because he was isolated, so thinking about it, nobody knows what he's doing, so you wouldn't be able to, like, you can't defend him either. It's hard to say that he was innocent because nobody would know what he's doing, so most of the things I said could have been true, and some of them were.
Just move on to my next question then. Do you have any evidence supporting your claim of Arthur Radley stabbing his father? What is it? If you don't have any evidence, then your testimony shows no credibility. So, moving on page 14, it said, Mr. Radley conceded but insisted that Boo not be charged with anything. He was not a criminal. If his own father claimed if his own father claimed that his son did not stab him, then wouldn't this be considered a false testimony? So, in conclusion, Your Honor, it has been clearly demonstrated that Ms. Stephanie Crawford is an unreliable witness and holds not one bit of credibility. Not only does she create baseless rumors, but she gets her information from untrustworthy sources. Thank you, Ms. Stephanie Crawford. That'll be all. I have no further questions. Thank you, counsel. Thank you.
Would you like to redirect your witness?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, on chapter 2, page 29, or 291, okay. Chapter 28, page 291, it says, that Bob had threatened Atticus, and I think that maybe Bob was trying to harm the kids. So,
is there a question in there for her?
Stephanie Crawford, do you think that Bob was trying to harm the kids?
Yes.
And do you think that Boo had an obsession with the kids? Yes. So, would you come to the conclusion that Boo would stalk the kids?
Mm-hmm.
And when he saw Bob Yule following them, could you think that it's possible that he was so obsessed with the kids that he was willing to kill someone? So, why do you think that, that is all.
Thank you, counsel. Would you like to dismiss your witness?
Yes. Stephanie Crawford be dismissed.
She may. Thank you. Prosecution, would you like to call up any further witnesses? Any other witnesses, prosecution? Did you forget what to say? You just say prosecution rests.
Prosecution.
Thank you, prosecution. Defense, would you like to call up any witnesses?
Yes, the defense would like to call up Jem Louise Finch.
This is Terry.
Could you please describe yourself to the court?
My name is Jean Louise Finch, but everyone calls me Scout.
All right, now, how do you know Arthur Radley, and what would you say were your relationship is?
Well, he's my neighbor. I never really met him. Well, I've only met him once. He saved my life. And he's real nice too. One time he put a blanket over my shoulders when I was really cold on the night of the fire.
And now, has Arthur Radley ever done anything to you or your brother to make you think that he would try to harm you in any way?
No, never.
Now, could you describe the night of the attack to us?
Well, Jem and I were walking back from the pageant. We were going home, and I was in my giant ham costume, and Jem heard footsteps. I didn't hear them at first, but later on, I heard them, and whenever we stopped, he stopped as well. Then suddenly, the attack just happened. Jem broke his arm in the process, and then Nathaniel Arthur Radley had saved both of us.
I know. What do you think would happen if Arthur Radley wasn't there to protect you that night?
Well, we could have been more injured and possibly even dead.
Would you like to cross-examine this witness, please, Keisha?
Scout, is it true that you've never seen Mr. Arthur Radley before until that night?
Yes.
Is it true that when you were walking home one night, you found knickknacks in a tree near the Radley lot, including medals, coins, etc., including a doll, like a soap doll shaped like you and your brother?
Yeah.
Wouldn't you agree that the night that you were walking home from the pageant, you and your brother heard strange noises?
We did. We
did you know who made the noises?
Well, I thought it was my aunt, Esther.
Okay. Is it possible that your vision was blocked during the attack?
My vision was blocked, but I heard everything.
And do you know who attacked?
Bob Buell.
How do you know? Because you said that your vision was blocked.
My vision was blocked, but... but I smelled this.
That could have been from the Radley lot as well, because his house is near.
Because later on, I don't think I smelled anything on him. And when I confronted Bob Ewell, he was the one that smelled the whiskey, no one else.
That's it. Thank you. Defense, would you like to redirect your witness?
Jeremy Finch, could you please describe who you are and how you know Arthur Radley?
I'm Jeremy Finch. I am Scout's older brother, and I know Boo Radley because he is my neighbor.